Hello family, this is Apostle Gideon. Welcome to Synesis of Christ for today. Our topic today is Jesus did not come for the righteous. Yes, Jesus did not come for the righteous. Our scripture is taken from Luke 19 verse 10. Jesus said, "The Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost." Yes, the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost. This verse was given us by the Lord when he was in Zacchaeus' house. Zacchaeus was notorious for his corrupt and wicked practices. He was a tax collector, and publicans or tax collectors in the time were seen as very corrupt people. For him to be a chief tax collector means that he was a chief sinner. Jesus, as his ministry was moving through Jericho and happened to locate Zacchaeus on a tree. Then he said, "I'll be in your house today." Who? Zacchaeus instantly repented. The man who was known to be a chief sinner repented and was ready to give everything that he has stolen back to the people he has stolen from. But not so fast. The religious people of the day were not so happy. They didn't want Jesus to have anything to do with the sinner. Then Jesus said, "The Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost." I want you to know, Jesus' mission was to save the world and that the world through him might be saved. He didn't come to put punishment on the world. He didn't come to pronounce punishment. He didn't come to cut people from God. He came to be the bridge that will restore people back to God. Amen. When you read John 3:16, 17, 18, it says, Jesus came not to condemn the world, that the world through him might be saved. Glory to God. Glory to God. So let's get our message rightly. This is not a time for anybody to run away from Jesus. If you are a preacher, I want to encourage you. The message is not that God wants to destroy people. The message is that Jesus has come to save them. Jesus has come to pay for the punishment that they deserve so that they can be restored back to God. I've traveled by the grace of God throughout the country this year from the north to the south, and what I hear many evangelists preach is appalling. This is not the gospel. Here many people preach and you get to think that the gospel or the message is become good and God will accept you. No, the message is that all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God, and Jesus has become the propitiation. He has become the one to take or the to pay for those sins so that man can be restored back to God. So the message today is that Jesus has come so that if you believe in him, all the wrongs you have done in your past, in your present, and even in your future will be taken care of so that you can be restored back to God. Yes, he came for us sinners so that we can be made the righteousness of God. 2 Corinthians 5, 21 says, he made him to be sin for us. Who knew no sin that in him will be made the righteousness of God? Yes. 2 Corinthians 5:19, "For God was in Christ reconciling the world unto himself, not counting their sins against them." God is no longer counting the sin of sinners against them. He's rather restoring them. He came for the sinner. The reason he came was so that sinners can be made right. Sinners can be restored back to God. Sinners can be reconciled. He wants people like Zacchaeus, people who are laden with sin, which everybody knows to be sinners, to come back to God. Hallelujah. He is our way back to the Father. Glory to God. So, my brother, wherever you have been, my sister, it is not too late for you. You can be restored back to God. Jesus came for you. The reason he died, the reason he was punished, was so that he can take your sins. Now, all of us who believe in him, he has taken our sins and he has made us right with God. Yes. So now, God is no longer holding my sin against me. I can pray freely. I can fellowship with God freely. And I hope that I will meet my Lord one day. That is why Jesus came. Glory to God. Yes. No need to run away from God. Even in your deepest sin, call on Jesus. The Bible says, "Whosoever shall call on the Lord shall be saved." Yes. He came so that you will call on him and be saved. Romans 10:13. Yes. Our confession today is this. Say, "Jesus came for me. He came to take my wrongs. He came to take my place so that I can be made right with God. Now I am reconciled with God. No need to be afraid of God." Hallelujah. Say amen, my brother. Say amen, my sister. And share this video. God bless you. See you tomorrow by the grace of God.